In this video, we're going to see about how to default your report to a latest fact date. Generally, like when you want to launch a report, it should be what is my previous day results, right? Yesterday, what has happened? Or whenever your business data is latest, you want to see the latest snapshot of it. You do not want to see the entire history in a snapshot, I mean, at the beginning. So in those cases, whichever is your latest data available in the fact or in your transaction tables, that date it has to be defaulted. But in general, Power BI doesn't have that feature. We need to do some DAX tricks to do it. Let us see in this video how to default it. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in DAX and Power BI. Now you can see it here in Power BI. We have a simple report here that is for the government's use cases. So on launching of the report, he do not want to see this entire history for now. In next pages or alternative pages, he can see that. But when, as soon as he launches, what happened yesterday? Okay, that snapshot he wants to have. So let us see what is the latest data here. Let us narrow down. On 2020, we have December. So December the 9th, 2020. This is the latest data, and this is his total sales. That is 4,600. So he wants to see that 4,600 here, and by product category wise, how much it has sold. So that snapshot he wants to see it in the first page as a launch, and in the history he can see whenever he required. And also, if the user wants to choose between one more day, say for example on launch of the screen he wants to see this 9th data, and user should have a capability to see the previous day data as well. How to achieve it? That is the end objective of this video. Let us try to do it using DAX. So the idea behind how to implement is like, we need to get this value, like whenever the latest data available in the fact table, that is the sales transaction table. This is the sales transaction table, which contains 9th of December 2020 is the latest. You need to get that date, and you need to calculate that figure as the sales amount. You need to default it. So instead of using directly the sales amount, okay, you need to use the calculated measure. Right, so people will think like using a max of value we can able to achieve it. Let us try to write step by step and what are the problems we'll face and what is the correct solution we will see in this video. Let's start writing. So measure, that is latest sales amount, okay, that will be my measure, and always it starts with calculate and sum of sales amount, right? Where is that sales amount? And what we can do is, so it is connected to dim date. I can use dim date or sales date also. For simplicity, I will use the sales date. Sales date is that sales date equal to max of sales date. Let us see, this is will give a wrong result, but people will think like writing like this will fix. Let us see what happens now. When I click on enter, so it says a max, a function max has been used, true or false, that is not allowed. Basically, max cannot be used here. So the idea behind this, you need to get the maximum date of sales and filter it, but you cannot do it. You need to wrap it in filter. So that is first formula is wrong. I'm trying the second version. Filter of sales. Okay, I will have entire, we need to write this is the syntax. We need to use filter sales, and then you need to use the sales data of max. Let us try to hit enter now. This works fine. So this will give the latest sales amount. Okay, then let us see what happens now. So let us copy this entire page, delete. I will copy it, duplicate. So here I should get 4.6. So where is that my latest sales amount? Here I need to use latest sales amount. I will replace it here. I think it is very small. Let us see. It should not be millions. That's okay. So we got 4600 now. You see here the same amount we are getting it. This is absolutely fine. Even I can use this latest sales amount here when I use this here. So here the problem comes. When you use it with date, what happens is like the filter context applies over here. Like for each sales date here, okay, for each sales date, which is nothing but a maximum. So I'm again getting the sales date here. So you cannot use it with the date dimension. Even I can use it here when I use over in the category, what happens now? So it says like 4000 and this is 1200 and this is something like 600. So totally it was 1200, 600, 1800 plus 4000, 5800. So what is happening here? So this DAX function seems to be wrong. The total seems to be fine. Okay, like it is giving me the ninth result, that is 4600. But when I use with other dimensions over here, it is collapsing, right? So let us try to understand with this scenario. I will remove it from here and let us understand what is happening. And I will say like when I click on casual VR, you see, I want this ninth result, right? The latest date. So the 4000 is appearing here. This is perfectly all right. What happens to formal? When you see the category formal, there is no data on 9th, okay? The data is available for 8th. That is summing up. So the filter context changing this query, right? This filter context is applied. So that is getting me the maximum date for this formal instead of 9th. So it should return 0. So this way of writing max of sales date is not working out. So we need something new. Let us copy this. Let us try to rewrite version 1. Latest sales amount 1. Okay. So in this, I'm going to write complete solution, right? So basically, you need to get the sales maximum sales date available in the sales table. For that, and let us store that one in a variable. So variable max sale date. Okay. And what I'm doing, calculate max of sale date, right? Max of sale date, comma, all of sales. So it, what it will do, it will ignore all the filters from the sales table. Whatever casual wear or dates, everything will be filtered. Give me maximum date in this sales table. That will be stored in your variable. Then now I can use this variable here, right? When I use this variable here, what happens now? Return. Okay, instead of directly using max, get the maximum value by removing all the filters from sales, then use that value. Now let us see the results. Okay, now you can see here the latest version 1. Now this seems to be good, right? I mean, let us see, let us copy this. Let us sales amount one. Let us sales amount here one, version one, right? So this is at the total level, it is fine. Let us try to understand from different dimensions perspective. So from casual wear, it is 4,000 and formal wear, we are not getting the value. Here it is 600. Let us try to view it as a table instead of confusion. So let us try to view it as a table. So let me slightly increase the column headers so that it will be easy for everyone to see, and as well as the value. Okay, now it's better. So basically the sales amount is available here. This is for the filtered the December month, because I have filtered here in this chart. And but what we need the latest date. So this is wrong. So we let us get rid of it. Now you can see the latest sales amount 4600 is appearing across different dimension. This dimension is working fine. The total is fine. And let us try to see it here. So even here you are not getting for all the dates, whereas the previous version you are getting the value for all the dates, right? That is what a problem happened. So now let us not have that one. So this yellow one, the previous one, it is getting for all the dates. That should not be the case. Fine, so now we have achieved it. But then we have defaulted all our reports to have only the latest date. Let us get rid of this. So now I will have a chart again. So now I will say like my report is having latest date. This is my previous date. So for sales date, I will bring it here using a label. That is not a label, this is a label, and I will say the latest. Okay, this is also fine. Everything seems to be under control now. Now what happens when user wants to change the data, right? Let us try to decrease the size. No, not here, this is for here. Let us make it 28, that will be perfectly all right. Okay, 26. Okay, now this is absolutely fine. And usually when you have the such kind of scenario, you are seeing the latest date. And here also you will have only the date combination, and users should have a ability to choose different dates, right? So once he chooses, this figure should change. For that, let me write a default measure. Okay, let me store this one variable as a default value, default sales. Okay, that should not be a value. I'm putting it in a variable. Then another variable that will have simple calculate sum of, because you are filtering the data and you are applying it. So I will say like variable sales actual equals this one. Okay, now when user filters data, right, when user filters a date for a previous date, say for example, now what happens? Okay, let us keep this one as such without confusing. Return calculate. Let us try to copy it and let us try to understand the problem, and then we will see it. So let us try to copy. So what I'm trying to say is here I will say like I will put date instead of this. So let me choose between, and here I'm saying 2020 December the 3rd. Okay, here December the 3rd. Now what happens? So this is not appearing because the sales amount is appearing. The latest data will not appear. Why? Because you are choosing a date, but this is filtering for the the particular date, right? I mean, the whatever measure we have used, the latest sales amount, which is appearing for the latest date. When there is nothing is chosen, without anything is chosen, you are getting the ninth data, that is the latest date. But when user chooses it, it has to return. For that, we need to write some, again, on top of this, you need to write some if condition. If user selected the dim date, then display just a sales amount. If not, show the default amount. That is what we need to write. So I'm just writing the final measure now. So latest sales final, okay. In ideal cases, you should not write like this. You can write normally whatever you like. I mean to say like sales amount. That's it. That should be your final measure name. Now for demonstration purpose, I use different versions. Now what I'm saying is, let us put this one, save it in another measure, default date, right? Default date equals. Then finally, we will have another measure where, no, another variable. It's not a measure, variable, actual sales equals calculate just sum of sales amount, right? Now return if dim date dot date, right? Okay, the small correction in it. So it should not be a date. So we should not have it since it is declared as a date dimension. So we should not have that one. Now you can see it here, right? This is having an issue that is only showing the default value. But when you choose different dates here, let me choose a date. I mean, let me type it instead of choosing it 2020. So when I choose some dates here, that is third, now it will not return any results, whereas this will return some date, right? I mean data. You see, if you sum it up these sales, this will come around 8700. So the formula is very simple, like when get the latest date from the sales and default it to the date if there is no selection is happening in the date. But when the user selected any of the dates, then show the actual sales amount. So this is the entire DAX you need to remember. This is how we can default report to a particular date, or it can be any other product or any other it can be any other dimension value as well. I hope you like this video, and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.